Hi guys, welcome to my channel. So a few days ago, a video surfaced online. In that video, Fowls was seen in that video condemning cybercrime and also criticizing musicians who encourage cybercrime. Ever since this thing dropped, Fowls been getting a lot of negative comments. We are gonna watch the video, but here are some of the things that he said. You're an entertainer in a position as a role model to younger ones coming up, and in your musical record, you're creating all the Yahoo Boys. It was referring to Nice's new song, which is Living Things. In that song, Nice mentioned some names, kind of glorifying Yahoo Boys in the song. Now Yahoo Boys are cyber criminals, guys who engage in fraudulent activities. He continued, he said, you are greeting all fraudsters, calling their names personally. Paint a picture, tell a story, don't glorify fraudulent behavior. It's not good.
I feel so strongly about this. Now, you are somebody, you are a entertainer, you are in a position as a role model to younger ones coming up, understand? And in your musical record, you are singing, you are greeting all the Yahoo Boys, you are greeting all the fraudsters, you are calling their name personally, you are hailing them. Oh, hey, this person, I don't know their name. So-so person. Wire, I'm over here, cha-cha. All this culture, you are making the younger ones to believe that it's cool to do it. It's not. You are destroying our future. Please stop it. As a entertainer, sing about something that can help our life. Paint a picture. Tell a story. Don't glorify fraudulent behavior. It's not good.
So after Fowls dropped the bomb, social media, he went gaga. Some people were against Fowls for saying that. People like this 8-year-old guy, you guys know this 8-year-old boy, Shegun Wire. I think a 9-year-old boy who got social media attention when a video of him emerged online, him saying when he grows up, he wants to become a Yao Yao.
Show the fresh to Baragua.
You
are my touch.
You are my
support long.
What a
lie.
This guy got into limelight through that video. On his Instagram page, he blasted Fowls, and here was what he said. I'm not sure I'm gonna be able to read everything. I should put out the screenshot here. You know, not the struggle. So why speak here of it, please? How many features have the Yahoo Boys destroyed? I beg. Shevina George, the Colette bride from back, even before court case, and soon our senior advocates never destroy features. You speak of soft work, only God knows your own definition of soft work, and why is nobody coming out to judge you for that term, soft work? Now, person talk chache, you they complain. Shena, your lapi, them they use. So, this was what the 9-year-old boy posted on his Instagram page, blasting Fowls for saying such a thing. And now, not only that, Nice's ex-wife, Tony Payne, is also out defending Nice's Living Things. But Nice, you know, has come out to talk about that, and he said he's not trying to promote anything, that is Fowls' perception of the song, that is not what he's trying to insinuate in the song.
People are thinking, is Fowls trying to strike a beef with you, trying to shade you, because he talked about the whole Living Things song and everything. What's your view on that?
First, I would say it's just his own opinion and perception about the song, or about Nigerian artists singing about such song. The song is not negativity, it's a positive song. The people that were mentioned in the songs are socialites. And if he has any proof that they are otherwise, then he can report them to EFCC and EFCC will take it up. But in terms of beef, that's not beef. He made a statement and it's time to be corrected. As a living thing, I want to be on top of things. I want to be doing things. I want to be controlling things. I want to be enterprising. What else do you want? For any job you want to do in your life, those four factors matter. So, and that's it.
Here was what Tony Payne said about this whole thing. I agree, the average Yahoo boy learned from his peers, not a song. So even without music, it will continue. My opinion though, she continued, she said, are you kidding me? Have you heard Ice Cube's music catalog? Even from NWA days, they were the worst. Funny enough, my favorite part of that song is I wanna be enterprising, I wanna be on top of things. Now she's talking about Living Things. That's the part that resonates with me. Said in other words, most of us are guilty of secretly or indirectly embracing naughty things. Some of us just wanna be hypocritical about it. Another one, she said, after all, music is also a beast. And most music artists will give their target markets what they want. Most will churn out what sells. So if you wish to motivate the artist to give you only conscious lyrics, do so by your actions, strength conscious music, and that's what you will get. Now, I agree with her about saying trend only conscious lyrics. I mean, the songs that we dance to, when you go back to check the lyrics, some of the lyrics are offensive, some of them are about illegal activities. Artists check out their target audience and try to give them what they want. So she made a good point here. She said it started from NWA days, mentioning Ice Cube. Now, if you check Black Americans, it actually affects them. She said, when you listen to lyrics, doesn't mean that you're gonna do what the artist actually stated in the lyrics. But I disagree with that, because not everybody. I listen to Lil Wayne, I've seen him talk about cocaine, I've seen him talk about guns, 9mm. Check out the blacks. You see them with the chains, with the grills, you know, on their teeth. These are the things they grew up to see. They see their older ones doing it. People are looking up to you as an artist. I love Lil Wayne, I listen to his songs. So it got to a point in my life, I thought tattoo the right thing to do. I tried to copy Lil Wayne. Here are some of the songs that promote Ford Stars. Now we have the band Mobolo, where he talks about ATM card, like what Damikrin got himself into, and Sauce Kid. Now here we have Olumente Yawuze. So back then, I know a lot of you guys know Yawuze. You know Maga Don't Pay by Kelly Hanson. And we have Too Much. Reminisce, we have nice, you know, living things. The problem I have with social media is the way double standard is being applied in dealing with this issue. When we heard the story about Damikrin, a lot of people started blasting Damikrin, and when we heard the story about Sauce Kid, a lot of people blasted Sauce Kid. It's funny, after Fowls' interview, a lot of people were against Fowls because of what he said. It's funny, seriously, I would want to say that whether we like it or not, it's a criminal act. It's a criminal act because it's been glorified by our musicians, by those we look up to. It doesn't make it legit, okay? So that's what I am gonna say. Let me know what you think about this in the comment section below. When I first listened to Wizkid to Dre Ledba, I thought Wizkid was just talking about hustling, which is normal. All Nigerians, we also, like, not only Nigerians, all over the world, it's all about hustling. So it's understandable. Looks like Wizkid is trying to portray Dre Ledba as a ghetto, which makes me